Miss Sarah here, and welcome to Hillcrest Kids. I hope you had a great and wonderful week, and thank you so much for joining me this morning to worship the Lord together. We're going to learn about a behind-the-scenes character who gave generously to a God's prophet named Elisha, and God rewarded her with a gift that no one can ever give her. So let's find out together about that. At this time, let's start the service with a prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this morning. Thank you for boys and girls who are watching the live stream this morning. Thank you so much for their heart to get to know you. And I pray that as we learn about you and sing unto you, that you'll be pleased and you'll be praised. And help us to take something in our hearts today, Lord. And bless the time. And I pray that we would make a decision to you, that you'll be pleased. Thank you so much for this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Boys and girls, sing with me and my kids. The first song we're gonna sing is If You're Happy and You Know It.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it.
Faithfulness, thy faithfulness.
Okay, boys and girls, let's turn our Bibles. Let's turn to 2 Kings chapter 4. 2 Kings is in the Old Testament. 2 Kings chapter 4, we're going to read 3 verses 8 through 10. So if you found your place, let's read together. 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 8, it says, "And it fell on a day that Elisha passed to Shunem, where was a great woman, and she constrained him to eat bread. And so it was that as oft as he passed by, he turned in thither to eat bread. And she said unto her husband, Behold, now I perceive that this is an holy man of God, which passeth by us continually. Let us make a little chamber, I pray thee, on a wall, and let us set for him there a bed, a table, and a stool, and a candlestick, and it shall be when he cometh to us that he shall turn in thither." Okay, boys and girls, today we'll learn about a woman who noticed the need of a preacher. She gave towards this need, and we will find out how God provided her with a reward that no one can ever give. So let's find out what kind of blessing she received from the Lord. The Shunammite provides meal for Elisha. This giving lady that we talked about earlier is another character that doesn't say her name in the Bible. And she is referred to as the Shunammite. The Shunammite had a heart for people though. And she noticed Elisha. Remember Elisha from last week's story? He was the prophet that healed Naaman from his leprosy, right? And in our story, Elisha traveled from town to town preaching God's word. And in his travel, he often passed through Shunem, which was the city that this Shunammite lady and her husband lived. When Shunammite noticed Elisha often passing by her town, she invited him to her house for a dinner. As Elisha, Shunammite, and her husband ate, the Shunammite said, "You know, God has been so good to us. He always blessed us and we have enough. And you travel through here so often, and our table will always be ready for you. Every time you pass by Shunem, come over to our house and we can have dinner together." So Elisha thanked the lady for dinner and the kind offer. And from then on, after that evening, every time Elisha passed through Shunem, he stopped for a meal at Shunammite's home. The Shunammite's husband makes a room for Elisha. One day, the Shunammite and her husband were talking about Elisha, and she said, "Elisha is a traveling preacher, and he's a holy man of God. But he never stayed over at our house to spend the night. I'm sure he has to find somewhere to stay after our dinner every time he stays. Maybe we could help him." She said, "Why don't we make a room so he and his servant Gehazi could stay with us when they pass through? We won't need, they won't need much. It will just need a bed, a writing table, a stool, and a lamp." And then her husband agreed with her and said, "There's no reason for Elisha to have a nice meal with us and leave and find somewhere to stay at night. Yes, he can stay with us. We have plenty of room." So they prepared a room for Elisha. And every time he and his servant Gehazi passed through Shunem, they went over to the Shunammite's house and stayed the night there. Elisha asked what he can do for the Shunammite. One day, Elisha was in his room at the Shunammite's house. He thought about how generous this lady and her husband has been to him, and he wondered what he can do for the couple. So Elisha called his servant Gehazi. He told him to go to the Shunammite and thank her for all the things that she had provided for them, and then ask her what he can do for her. So Gehazi went to the Shunammite lady and thanked her for the food and the beautiful place that they stay in. And then he asked what Elisha can do for her. for him, her and her husband. But her response was a no thank you. She said, I can't think of anything. I have everything I need. I live in a nice town with my husband, my relatives, and my friends. I have a comfortable house and a happy life. There's nothing I really want or need. Gehazi returned to Elisha and told him what she told him. And Elisha said, well, that's too bad. I really wanted to do something for her in return. Do you have any ideas, Gehazi? Then the reward of a son. You know, Gehazi said, the Shunammite doesn't have any children, and her husband is very old. Elisha said, perfect. Call the Shunammite. As the Shunammite stood at the doorway of Elisha's room, Elisha said, about a year from now, you will give a birth to a son. And the Shunammite couldn't believe her ears. She started to cry and said, oh, please don't lie to me. Because she and her husband, they've been married for a long time, but they never had any children. And what Elisha had promised came true. The following year, she gave birth to a son. The child becomes sick and dies. As the Shunammite's son grew older, he loved to go out to the field with his dad and his hired servants. One day, when he was out in the field with his father, he was watching the workers harvesting the crops, and he started to feel a headache. And when his pain grew and grew, he went to his father and cried, "My head, my head!" His father quickly called one of the servants and said, take him to the house and to his mother. So the servant took the boy to the house and the mother carried him. And at home, his mother held the boy in her arms and the boy's headache didn't go away and didn't get any better. The Shunammite didn't know what to do. And finally at noon, the boy died. The Shunammite knew what she had to do. It was the prophet. Well, she thought it was the prophet who promised me the son. And God blessed me through the prophet. So I must go and see him. So she carried the son's body to Elisha's room and put him down in Elisha's bed. And she shut the door and she saddled the donkey and went her way to Elisha. The reward of healing. At home, Elisha saw someone coming towards his house off in the distance. So he called Gehazi. Gehazi, go see who that is. And Gehazi noticed that it was the Shunammite lady. And Elisha said, that's odd for her to come to my house today. Go run up to her and ask her what's wrong or if everything is okay. But the Shunammite passed Gehazi and fell down in front of Elisha and caught him by the feet. And she started to cry. And she said, I never asked for a son. Remember, I told you I have everything I need. And I told you, don't you lie to me about having a son? Then Elisha realized that something was wrong with the son. So he said to Gehazi, go to Shunammite's house and lay my staff upon the child's face. And he sent him right away. But Shunammite said, that's not enough. You need to come with me. I will not leave you until you come to my house with me. So Elisha and the Shunammite lady went to Shunem together and met Gehazi at her house. Gehazi said, the child is not awakened. Elisha went into his room and in the Shunammite's house and saw the child laying on his bed. And Elisha closed the door and he prayed there. Lord, only you can give life. Please restore this Shunammite's son's life. Then Elisha stretched his body over the boy's body. And then he got up. He went back and forth in the room, asking God to heal the boy, praying. And then he went back to the boy's body, and then stretched out his body again over his. Then, miraculously, the boy sneezed 7 times and then opened his eyes. Elisha called, "Gehazi, go call the Shunammite." The Shunammite came to the door and saw that her son was alive. She thanked Elisha over and over and brought her son out of that room and took him to her house. She knew her son was a gift from God and believed that God can bring him back to life again through his servant, the prophet Elisha. So that's the story for today. But let's think about a few things here. The Shunammite probably had a very nice home with a lot of land and hired servants. She and her husband were most likely very wealthy because the Bible calls her a great woman, which means that she was very well known in her town with a lot of money and influence. But you know, boys and girls, not everybody who has money is a giver. Sometimes people who have more money think mostly about themselves and their possessions, and they don't think about the needs of the other people. So it wasn't the Shunammite's wealth that made her to be a giver, but it was her heart. She noticed her wealth, but she also noticed other people's needs. So she gave Elisha a nice dinner meal every time he passed by Shunem. And she noticed that Elisha needed somewhere to stay. So she and her husband gave Elisha a room to stay. When she gave to Elisha, God blessed her with a son that she probably wanted for a very, very long time. But notice that she didn't give because she wanted something in return from the prophet or God, right? She only gave because she loved God and she loved the people of God, the preacher. So we can learn from the Shunammite not only to be a giver, but to be a good noticer. Boys and girls, to be a good giver, we need to notice some of these things here. Notice other people's needs. Do they need food or water? Do they need clothing? Do they need money? Do they need a place to stay? Do they need friendship? Do they need a kind word? Do they need the Lord? See, boys and girls, there are so many people around us who are in need. And for us, our job is to notice these things and meet their needs. So notice with me, notice what we have. We have enough food and water. We have enough clothes. We have enough money. We have a roof over our heads. We have the ability to be a friend. We can say kind words to others. We have the Lord as our Savior. So boys and girls, when we see someone else's needs and we have that need, then we need to fulfill it for other people and show God's love to them. If they don't know Christ as your Savior, this is a perfect opportunity to give and share the gospel message with them. If your friend is discouraged and sad and not wanting to do anything, then you can be a friend to that person and encourage her or him. And if there's a person who doesn't know Christ as their Savior, you can share the gospel message with them. You can share that Jesus loves them and that Jesus died for their sins. And if they trust Jesus as their Savior, then they can have heaven as their home as well. So boys and girls, give from your hearts. When you give from your heart, when you see the need of other people, then God will bless you. God may give you back what you gave. For example, if you gave food to a friend that was in need, maybe God will give you that same thing to fulfill your needs. Or he may give you something far better. If you gave a toy to a friend who was in need, then God might give you something far better than a toy. So God can give you the same thing that you gave or something far better. In our story, Shunammite lady, she didn't need a dinner, fancy dinner. She didn't need an extra room that she gave, but God gave her something far better, which was a son, right? But give without expecting to receive anything back. Then you will receive God's blessings in your life. In 2 Corinthians 9:6, it says, "But this I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully." So as you give, boys and girls, bountifully, a lot, with all your heart, then God will give you, God will bless you bountifully. He will give you more. So, boys and girls, I want you to try giving and see the blessings of giving and see God's hand upon your life. Let us all pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this day and thank you for the story that you have given us in the Bible. I pray that as we have listened to this story of this Shunammite, how she gave with a willing heart and a loving heart to God's prophet, help us to learn, Lord, that there is so much, much more in giving. Help us to give towards the needs of other people so that we may experience your blessings in our lives. Not because we want those blessings, but help us to love other people by giving. Help us to see the needs of others so that we may receive the blessings and the happiness in giving, Lord. I pray that you'll be with the boys and girls, Lord, that they will take this to their heart and help them to practice it with their friends or even their siblings and their families, Lord, so that you can bless them with the joy in their hearts and also some of the materials that they would need in the future, Lord. Thank you so much for this day and thank you for the word of God. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, boys and girls, here are the review questions. Question number one, what is the giver's name in our story?
We don't know. We call her the Shunammite.
Good job. Number two, to whom did the Shunammite give?
To Elisha, the prophet of God.
Awesome job, you guys. Number three, what was the first thing the Shunammite gave to Elisha?
He gave him meals at her home.
Awesome, you guys are really good. Number four, what did she ask her husband?
If they could furnish a room for Elisha and his servant Gehazi.
Awesome job. Number five, how did the Shunammite answer Gehazi when he asked her what Elisha could do to repay her?
She didn't need or want anything.
That's right. Number six, what did Gehazi realize the Shunammite didn't have?
Child.
Number seven, what did the Shunammite do when her son died?
She went to Elisha for help.
Awesome job listening, guys. Number eight, what did Elisha do to help the Shunammite son?
He prayed for him and stretched himself across him, and his life came back to him.
Here's the last question for today. Number nine, does God always reward us for giving?
Yes, but often it is not with the same thing we gave or in the way we would expect.
Awesome job, you guys.
You did great.
It's game time, boys and girls. Today, we'll play a game we played before called Match 'em Up. Match the puzzle pieces to make up a word from today's lesson. I may give you a hint, so listen carefully. Here's the first one. Can you match two puzzle pieces to make up a word? You have 10 seconds. Here's a hint. It's the name of a person. Did you get it? The answer is Elisha, the prophet from our story. Here's the next one. Match two pieces together. You have 10 seconds. Yes, the answer is give. Can you match two pieces together again? You have 10 seconds. Good job! The answer is room. How about this one? Can you match three puzzle pieces to make up a word? 15 seconds starts now. Here's a hint. It's the lady we talked about today. Yes, the answer is Shunammite. Match three pieces together again. 15 seconds starts now. Here's a hint. The Shunammite and her husband put this in Elisha's room. I hope you got it. The answer is table. Here's the last puzzle game. Match three pieces again to make up a word. 15 seconds starts now. Here's a hint. The Shunammite's boy cried at the field saying this. The answer is my head. Great job, everyone. Now here's a bonus game. Find the differences in these two pictures. I'll give you 1 minute. Here's the answer. I hope you got them all. Thanks for playing, everyone. Awesome job.
Students, I just want to take a moment and say congratulations and let you know how proud my wife and I are concerning your promotion. We want to let you know that we're praying for you, that we love you very, very much, and that we're so grateful that your family is in our church. Well, let me encourage you to keep pressing forward for the Lord and keep loving the Lord Jesus Christ. Obey and honor your parents. Be faithful to the church, and God will bless you and God will use you in a mighty way. He has a wonderful future and a wonderful plan for your life. And so keep trusting in our Savior here this morning. Well, once again, congratulations on your promotion.
Church family, just want to say congratulations to my son Brian Ramirez for his graduation in high school, and we're so proud of him. We love you, Brian.
We love you, Brian, and I want to thank all of the church family members, pastor, you and Sarah, everybody that came, and Nate, we couldn't have done it without you. Thank you guys. You guys are the best.
Thank God.
And we're so proud of you, Brian. Have a
Bless
great
you all.
Day. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Congratulations, Brandon, from promoting from the 8th grade. We just want to let you know how proud we are of you for your hard work and your dedication. We also want you to know that we will always support you and that we will always be here for you and that we love you. I continue to pray that you will strive and that you will do your best for the years to come, and always remember how much we love you. Congratulations.
Ethan, we just want to tell you how much we love you, and we're so proud of everything that you've accomplished in middle school. You really do make us proud, and we're not just because of your studies and your grades, but you're such a kind-hearted soul, and we see that you're always trying your best in everything that you do, and that's all we can ever ask for. I just want you to know that we are always going to be here for you. We will support you through everything in your life. And we pray to God that He watches over you and guides you through high school and throughout your life. We love you so much, baby, and I'm so, so proud of everything that you've done.
Hey, Katie, we just wanted to congratulate you on this big moment in your life of finishing elementary school and moving on to middle school.
And we're excited to see what God's plan is for you, and we love you very much.
Congratulations, Dominic. You're moving on to the big kid class from nursery. Be a good boy, be a good listener, and pay attention. Love you, Wapo.
Hi, Nathan. Mommy and Daddy would like to tell you how proud we are of you, and how fast you're learning and growing, and how excited we are for your future in the house of the Lord, and that you just continue to keep growing and learning and serving God. We love you so much, baby. Bye.
just wanted to tell you that we love you so much and we're so proud of you.
And I want you to know that we're both praying that the Lord will guide you throughout the rest of your life.
We love you.
Love you, bud. Bye.
So proud of you, promoting from sixth grade and getting into your next chapter of youth ministry. Love you.
Congratulations.
Hey Sammy, just want to congratulate you on your promotion from sixth to seventh grade.
God bless you.
We love you.
Boys and girls, thank you for joining me this morning again. I hope all of you had a fun time learning God's word together. I am praying for all of you, so if you have any prayer requests, please let me know. I hope you have a wonderful Sunday and a great week, and let's meet again next Sunday at 9:45. Have a good week. Bye, everyone.